My name's Adam. What are your names?
I'm Angie.
You're Angie.
I'm Christine.
My name is Adam. We are Change Minnesota, Uptown Art Fair, and we're going to have like kind of a little quiz show here. Here we go.
Here we go. Who's that?
I have no clue.
I have no idea.
No, I hate football.
Not really.
I have no idea who that is either.
Aaron Rodgers, Super Bowl champion from the Packers.
Still don't know who that is.
Okay. I don't either.
MJ!
Perhaps not.
No.
Okay, give me one quick fact about MJ.
He died.
Oh, that was mine.
New one.
I don't know. He does a Thriller.
He has a kid named Blanket.
Okay. Next.
Next picture.
Justin Timberlake.
Justin Timberlake.
Everybody knows JT. Give me a fact.
NSYNC.
He once dated Britney Spears.
Very good. He's a Grammy Award winner, I believe.
Lady Gaga.
I'll fact check it later.
Yep, that's Lady Gaga. Give me a fact. Quick fact.
She's hot.
There we go. She's hot.
I agree.
There you go. That guy.
He's Willis. An actor.
Armageddon?
He's been in?
No, he's in Armageddon.
He was in some bank robbery movie.
He was married to Demi Moore before Ashton Kutcher locked that down. Next one.
I bet he feels bad now.
Right.
Charlie Sheen.
Quick fact.
He's a hot mess.
Okay.
I like 2 and a Half Men. That's my fact. That's my fact.
Winning.
JFK.
That is JFK. We're going like deep political here. One of the best presidents ever.
He was very good from what I hear.
He was good. Martin Luther King.
Thank you.
Quick fact about Martin Luther King.
I have a dream.
There we
yeah,
go.
Yeah, this famous like speech, I have a dream.
They were both assassinated.
Behind both.
Correct.
Right on.
Both heavily involved in the civil rights.
Break the civil rights.
How
about this guy?
Obama!
Barack Obama.
Do you guys like him?
I do like him.
You voted for him?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. Quick fact, though, apart from that, that you voted for him.
Current president, that's all I got.
I watched his inauguration in Times Square.
Watched his inauguration in Times Square?
It was pretty sweet.
Okay.
That's all I got.
This is an older one.
This is a tough one.
I like his glasses.
I know that dude.
I don't know.
No quick facts?
No. Mm-mm.
This is Alan Greenspan. Alan Greenspan is the former head of the Federal Reserve. You guys know what the Federal Reserve
yes,
is?
Yes, actually. I used to work at a bank. I know that.
Heck
yeah. I did not work at a bank.
Okay, quick fact, the Federal Reserve is not a federal entity, it is a private central bank. Next picture.
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know.
I'll give you a hint. You remember the picture of Alan Greenspan before?
Yes. That was his lawyer.
Good guess. This is the current chairman of the Federal Reserve.
Oh, that would make sense.
And a quick fact about that, this guy has now created $16 trillion, and he's passed them out to foreign and too big to fail domestic banks, our tax dollars. $16
trillion. What a bastard.
Who's this guy?
A very cute old man.
He's cute.
I don't know who he is.
He has courage out of anybody. He wants to... Who is he?
He wants to feed the poor.
You could say that.
What else did you want to do?
I don't know who he is.
This, right there.
Ron Paul.
Congressman Ron Paul. Woohoo! Legalize it.
That's awesome. I'm all for Ron Paul now.
How do you feel about that? How do you feel about the drug war and the fact that it's costing us about $800 billion a year?
I think if you tax that shit, we'd make a lot of money.
Wouldn't that make more sense than like arresting nonviolent offenders?
And I don't even smoke it. And I'm like, do what you ever want. Whatever. Yeah. I don't do what you want to do.
Right? Yeah, it's like another fun fact. The American prison system is in fact incarcerated more people combined than any other Western nation combined. So, and most of them are actually small-time drug offenders.
I don't get it. I just sigh at this fact. Like, as long as you don't hurt me, same with gay marriage. I don't care. As long as you're not hurting me.
You have to pay some of your income or your property taxes to support
it. Exactly.
Right? Right.
Yeah. Exactly.
Exactly. Right. Yeah. Right. I agree.
This shouldn't be wasting our taxpayer dollars
no.
even talking about it in a courtroom or a legislature.
Like, all I can do is roll my eyes at it.
Right. What about, like, you know, unuseful topics like that or talking about a federal level, like abortion and all those things? You think that should be left to the state level? To the counties? I mean, where do you draw the line for the big old government curtain?
Do you think it would be easier to perhaps hold these politicians who make these weird laws accountable on a local level or on a broad scale?
I think it would be easier. I don't know a lot about government politics. I think it would be easier on a state-to-state level to hold them accountable. But I think big things like that that affect everyone should be federal.
You don't hear about that a lot, though, like more responsibility on a local level, like... you know, grassroots politics, like getting involved in your...
The Constitution's drafted to where it gives all the states the powers to make the laws that they choose. And then basically the idea is if you don't like the laws of the land, you can move to another state. What do you fear?
Oh my God. People don't, I mean, wasn't this country founded on like people having rights and the freedom to, like, this country was founded on freedom, and now it feels like we just take that, like, take their rights away, and that's not fair.
Why do you suppose it is that the mainstream media doesn't tell us more about those political figures than they do about the celebrity figures? Do you think their job is to inform us or entertain us?
Well, I think their job should be to inform us, but...
They're using it as entertainment.
Absolutely.
And they're afraid of reactions, so they hide.
Goes back to his question earlier.
People were more informed about everything that's going on instead of just being fed this kind of bull crap from the mainstream media, that they would really be irritated and upset about what's happening and stand up and do something?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So, yeah.
Absolutely. Because you can't even watch the right media without getting the right information.
Yeah. The idiocracy of the people is getting too intense and that basically they're being led to this line, right?
Yes.
What do you think we can change that?
I think we need to inform people more. I think mainstream needs to stop. I think, you know, even talking about it now has got me more interested in it, know that I need to do my research. I think more people just need to start talking. Like, even just on a local, face-to-face level, people just need to start talking about it.
You won't get swine flu from eye contact, right?
I like that. It's very true.
There's a big campaign going on right now, especially with Ron Paul running for president, basically to reinstate the Constitution, eliminate the Federal Reserve, and bring our country back to the founding values, bring our troops home, protect our country, grow industry in our country again, put everybody to work, and let the illegal bankers collapse and kick them out.
I think sometimes we just need to completely revamp and start over, and hopefully things will go well next time. Yeah.
So when you guys leave, you're looking into Ron Paul more?
Yes.
Yes.
If you're right here, what would you tell him?
I would say good for you, and I will research you a little more.
Awesome.
Yes. Cool. Thank you so much. You guys are great.
Yeah, thank you.
Fantastic.
We're doing this for you, Dr. Paul. We're spreading the word.
For America.
We're helping abolish the Federal Reserve. We're fighting for Anonymous and all those guys, all the hacktivists out there. We're going after. We're doing this for you guys.
We're doing this for?
We're doing this
for you.
We're doing this for Dr. Ron Paul.
Who?
Dr. Ron Paul.
And what is he doing?
He's going to end the Federal Reserve.
As how?
He's going to abolish it. He's going to audit and then abolish the Federal Reserve.
Why should they have to abolish the Federal Reserve?
Because they are inflating us into poverty, basically.
Cool. So.
And the Fed, Ron Paul, 2012. We're out and about trying to educate the people.
Woo!
Constitution is good for democracy, smaller government.
There we go.
Hell yeah.
It's gonna be fun. We're gonna get outside for a
wanted to ask you, what is the one thing you fear?
The one thing I fear?
Yes.
I fear a police state. We have a privatized prison system, and it's a for-profit prison system. And to me, that says that policing is a for-profit endeavor, and it shouldn't be.
Oh, so you guys kind of seem reluctant about things. What do you think? Are you looking for Ron Paul for as president, or are you supporting him?
I like what he's got going. I feel strongly that Obama ran a big thing about for change and all this. It was a bunch of empty promises because it's part of the machine. And Ron Paul seems like not a fresh face because he's well established in, I'm not sure if he's in the House or the...
He's a congressman. Yeah, he's
right. I know he's in the Congress. Right. And he's well established in that, but it seems like he is a real choice for someone different. But then again, he is part of the machine, so it's hard to say if he really is.
He's been within the Congress for almost 30 years.
Which is awesome.
He's known as Dr. No, you know, which is no to all the new bills that infringe upon the Constitution. And once people kind of understand what the Constitution is, they should kind of really
move so far away from that. And we need to get back to that before we lose what we have.
Well, these states, we wouldn't have any real threats or any real risk if we didn't occupy other foreign countries. The biggest impact on all of us is that we actually have to borrow from the Federal Reserve in order to go occupy all these countries, and then the taxpayers through your income taxes pay the debt to the Federal Reserve system.
Exactly.
So and we're never going to do this as a country.
Who runs the Federal Reserve exactly, because it's owned by foreign powers?
Shadow government.
International bankers, right?
Shadow yeah. government.
And that is, I mean, we're borrowing against our enemy.
Correct.
So
we're just going to keep going down a deeper depression. Every one of these bailouts and great things that they're doing for our country are actually just adding to this tremendous amount of debt.
So
and eventually it's going to collapse, right?
Each new kid that's born in the world now, how much debt do they have when they're born?
They don't even know, we can't even audit the Federal Reserve.
It's all credit.
Yeah.
But all great powers end. And exactly. It is what it is. But I don't know, we're definitely interested and we'll keep in touch. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. All right.
Are we violating any laws now? Because we are. I mean, I understand that they're renting the streets. They're obtaining the permits to kind of control this area and shut down streets and hire law enforcement to help out.
Because this is their art fair, and they want it so that people can walk through here without being attacked and bothered by people with cameras and microphones. They're here to enjoy the art fair, enjoy the city here.
We abide by the copyright laws, and anybody that says
we're not talking about copyright laws. You're talking apples and oranges. Don't give me a red herring here, okay? I'm asking you to move along, okay?
We understand.
And same for tomorrow. If you want to go down to the next street, that's great. Knock yourself out. If you want to go down there by the lake, great. There's more people down there.
Freedom of speech zone, and I'm just trying to understand, officer.
I'm not telling you can't have a freedom of speech. I'm talking about being in people's faces with a microphone and a camera, because some people don't want to be photographed. Some people don't want to be microphoned. So I'm asking you to move down that way or the other side of 34th.
Take it back home.